This is a coaxial digital audio cable. This one is around half a meter in length. So what if you want a longer cable? Let's say, for example, a 5 meter or a 10 meter cable. What are you supposed to do? Because finding that cable in the shops is going to be troublesome. It's also not advisable to cut this cable in half and join it. Well, hello there. My name is Dominic, and today I'm going to show you how to make your own custom coaxial digital audio cable. These are the materials you're going to need: two RCA connectors and your custom length of coaxial cable. And these are the normal RCA connectors you are used to for audio and video. And the coaxial cable is the normal cable we use for our analog, digital, and satellite TV. It's just a normal 75 ohm cable. Make sure you get a quality cable. And these are the tools that you are going to need: a side cutter, long nose pliers, and a utility knife. I'm probably going to need a soldering iron and some solder, but I'm not sure. Let's see how this video goes. I will start by snipping off both sides of my cable so that I can get a flat surface to start with. Just score the insulation, don't cut it through so that we avoid cutting the strands. Again, just score the insulation and remove it, just like that. And for my cable, I'm going to bend the innermost cable in half using my long nose pliers. I'll also need to spread apart this part and insert my cable like that. And now I will use the long nose pliers to press the cable tightly. Now, there are those RCA connectors that have a small screw that you tighten the innermost conductor to, but mine doesn't seem to have that. So I'm probably going to need a small dab of solder for that inner conductor. I will do the same on the other side, and don't forget to insert this first, and then the plastic sleeve next. I'll try to do a cleaner job on this other side. Make sure these strands do not touch the innermost conductor. This step is completely unnecessary, but I just want peace of mind. Close it up. Now it looks more beautiful. Do you think it's going to work? Let's test it. Let me quickly explain my testing procedure. This is a Vitron TV with a coaxial digital out port. One end of my cable will go into the coaxial port, and the other end will go into this small box. This is a digital to analog audio converter. I will power it using this phone charger. And the audio out, which is in analog form, I have connected to this Bluetooth speaker.
AUX play.
Let's test that. And what is making the music right now is this Bluetooth speaker. You can see that my coaxial cable actually works. I've even seen articles where they say that this cable can be as long as half a kilometer long. Half a kilometer. Well, that is impressive. Now, you must agree with me, that was very simple and straightforward. Although coaxial digital audio is not used very much nowadays, it has been overtaken by optical, which has been overtaken by HDMI ARC, which is now being overtaken by HDMI ARC. Now, I have two other videos. One is about coaxial digital audio, and the other one is about HDMI ARC as well as EARC. I'll put a link to both the videos in the video description below as well as in the pinned comment. That's it. I hope you learned something new today. Please like, subscribe, hit that bell notification icon and share this video with your friends. Let's meet in the next video and goodbye.